Hi, my name is Julie Sievers, and in this video, I'm going to discuss chlorine residual measurement and the required minimum chlorine levels. Chlorine is used to oxidize iron and as a disinfectant. In this video, we're going to discuss chlorine as a disinfectant. In Iowa, a system that treats their water must disinfect unless the treatment is a package unit. The minimum chlorine levels are 0.3 milligrams per liter of free chlorine or 1.5 milligrams per liter of total chlorine. The level depends on if you're using free chlorine or chloramines in the disinfectant. There'll be more on this later. Disinfection is used to kill harmful bacteria and viruses. It does not sterilize the water, and it does not kill all of the bacteria. Pathogens such as cryptosporidium protect themselves from chlorine. Disinfection is one of the many ways or one of the many barriers to keep water safe. A chlorine residual is required to be maintained throughout the distribution system to protect the water system. Chlorine residuals are typically measured with a test kit and must be measured immediately. Portable or benchtop colorimeters are strongly recommended. Color wheels are strongly discouraged as they depend so much on personal interpretation of the color. It is very important that the sample used for chlorine measurements be representative of the water to be measured. In the distribution system, this means that you must let the water run to clear the internal plumbing and service line. Typically, the water temperature can be used as an indicator because the temperature will typically stabilize when the water is from the main. The sample site should not be softened or have any other in-house or point-of-use treatment, such as a filter, RO unit, or other device. Many of these treatment devices will remove chlorine. It is extremely important that you follow the appropriate sample collection procedure to ensure your results are accurate and reflect the actual conditions of your water. Another important factor is the condition of your analysis equipment, particularly the sample vials. Colorimeters measure the difference in the color of light across the sample vial, so dirty or discolored sample vials will impact the results and will often give inaccurate results. Be sure to wipe off any fingerprints before reading the chlorine level. It is also important to keep the sample compartment clean and dry. You are encouraged to have dedicated vials for free and total chlorine, one for each test. A challenge, particularly during the summer, is condensation on the sample vials. This will interfere with the measurement. Wiping off the vial to remove the condensation is very important. To collect a sample, run the water until the temperature is stable and you are sampling the water from the main. Rinse your sample vials three times with the water being sampled. Depending on your instrument, samples of 10 mils or 25 mils are collected. Be sure to read the sample instructions for your specific instrument. It is also very important to be sure your reagents are for the method you are using. Reagents are available for 5, 10, or 25 milliliter samples. I'm going to show you the analysis using a hot pocket colorimeter too. Be sure to check the instructions for your specific instrument. This test kit uses 10 milliliter samples. Fill the sample vials to the 10 milliliter line. I am doing the measurement on the low range scale, and the highest level that can be measured is 2.2 milligrams per liter. If a reading flashes at you or reads over limit, the value is greater than the upper limit of your testing equipment. You do not know the value other than that it is greater than 2.2 milligrams per liter. In these situations, you must dilute or use the high range scale. To use the high range scale in the hot pocket colorimeter too, you must change the scale, use the plastic vials with the indented sides, use 5 milliliters of sample and 2 reagent packets. To measure free chlorine on the low range scale, fill the sample to the 10 milliliter line. Wipe the vial and place the vial in the instrument. It is very important to line up the mark on the vial with the mark on the instrument. It is important to always line up the vial in the same orientation so you measure across the vial in the same way. Zero the instrument. Remove the vial and add 1 reagent packet. Shake the vial to mix. Wipe the vial and read the value immediately. The free chlorine must be measured immediately and record the value. To confirm that you are using free chlorine as the disinfectant, measure the level on this same sample at 30, 60, 90, and 120 seconds. If this value increases, you are using chloramines and do not have true free chlorine. If the value is stable or does not change more than 0.1 milligrams per liter, you are using free chlorine and the minimum free chlorine residual is 0.3 milligrams per liter. The free chlorine residuals must be greater than 0.3 milligrams per liter throughout the distribution system, except in very low use areas. If your free chlorine measurement was not stable, meaning the values increased over the time, you are chloraminating and the free chlorine is false. You do not have free chlorine residual in your system. In this situation, you must maintain at least a 1.5 milligram per liter total chlorine residual throughout the distribution system, except in very low use areas. To measure total chlorine, fill the sample vial to the 10 milliliter line. Wipe the vial and place the vial in the instrument. Zero the instrument. Remove the vial, add the reagent, shake to mix, and wait at least 3 minutes, but no more than 6 minutes. Some instruments have a timer, and if yours does, start the timer. After the time of at least 3 minutes, wipe the vial, insert it into the instrument in the same orientation as you did when you zeroed it, and read the value. If the instrument reads over limit or 2.2 and flashes at you, you need to dilute the sample or change to the high range scale and follow the appropriate method to read on the high range scale. On the HOC, pocket colorimeter 2, that means changing to the high range scale, using the plastic vials with indented sides, using 5 milliliters of sample and 2 reagent packets. Again, be sure to check the instructions for your specific instrument. It is important to wash your vials immediately after the test so they do not become discolored, as the reagent will stain the vials. This will interfere with the test and give you inaccurate results. Chlorine residuals must be measured daily at the source entry point and in the distribution system if you add chlorine to the water. You must also measure and report chlorine residuals with your bacteria samples. Refer to your operation permit for your system-specific requirements.